Before you book your cataract surgery, stop and think, are you getting the best lens? I tested two different lenses in each eye of the same patient. We will listen to the patient explain this experience shortly. I'm about to show you the ultimate test with two of the most popular lenses today, Panoptix and Odyssey. Not statistics or boring graphs and data, but the same person with the same brain and the same pair of eyes seeing the world through two different lenses. Which lens is better? In this test, I will check the vision in each eye separately for distance, intermediate, and near vision. And I will also check for possible glare and halos. After that, I will do analysis and my final conclusion. We will see Robert shortly. He had cataract surgery just a few weeks ago.
Today we have a Robert who had cataract surgery. I put an Odyssey lens in the left eye and a Panoptix lens in the right eye. And I'm just going to ask him a few questions to find out. I want to see from this in the same person which lens performs better. These lenses are both, we measured his prescription is very close to zero in both eyes. So the only difference that we will see is the difference of the actual function of the lenses. So Robert, in general, just tell me, how do you feel with your eyes? How is your vision? How are you feeling in general?
Overall, very good. Distance is great. Close up, there's a little difference between the two. The right eye, I can see closer up than I can with the left. That's sharp.
In general, how is your functioning without glasses during the day?
Yeah. Going? No glasses. I don't use glasses at all.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Now, I want to do a few tests. We're going to have you take a look for distance. What I want you to, with distance, you can see 20/20 in both eyes. Okay. But what I'm asking right now is a more specific question. I want to see him, I want to see subjectively which eye he's seeing better with. The right eye, which is the Panoptix, or this one, which is the Odyssey. Which one is clearer for distance?
The distance would be the Odyssey. It's a little bit sharper.
So the Odyssey is a little bit sharper for distance. Now let's take a look at near. For near, I'm going to get some lighting here also. So we're going to hold it this distance. Which line can you see here?
I can see the bottom line, 428739.
Okay, so this is the line that he saw, the bottom line, which is the 20/20 line. How about with the Odyssey? Turn it to the other eye. Which line do you see?
Be the one above it.
Really?
937826.
Okay, so this is the line that he just read with the Odyssey. Now, another thing that I want to know is the, in the intermediate, if there is any difference between them. If I hold it a little bit further here, the right and the left, which one sees a smaller line?
The right, and obviously the, I can see the second one from the bottom there.
Okay, now switch.
And that one is going to be the one above it, 3Z.
Okay, so the Odyssey, the Panoptix saw better both for near and intermediate, had a one line better vision compared to the Odyssey. And the Odyssey saw slightly better subjectively for distance. They were both 20/20, but subjectively, Odyssey was a little bit clearer than the Panoptix for distance. Now, what I'm going to check is for glare and halos. I'm going to basically turn off the light, and I'm going to turn off this light as well. And again, one more time, if you don't mind, just fold this. What I want you to do is to look at this light and tell me which one of those two lenses you see more glare or halos around the lights with which eye.
I see a little bit more with the, I see more halos, more rings with the left eye, the Odyssey, actually.
Yeah.
I see two or three rings here, and I see another ring and a little more flare, a little more glare.
Good.
So what did we learn? Robert had clearly better near and intermediate vision with the Panoptix lens. The vision for distance was somewhat better with the Odyssey. Also, the glare and halos were not significant with either lens, but slightly more prominent with the Odyssey. However, these tend to diminish significantly within a few months. So what's the conclusion? It's certainly not as obvious as you think, and my recap may actually surprise you. But first, let me answer another question. Why put a different type of lens in each eye? You see, each lens has a unique set of benefits. Combining them allows the patient to enjoy both benefits at the same time. For example, each lens may have unique benefits in certain lighting conditions or provide a sharper vision for either near or distance. Even more important is the reduced chance that both eyes may experience the same potential side effects like glare or halos at the same time. So what do we learn from this? Does this mean that Panoptix is overall a better lens? Well, it certainly does not. I can tell you that I had other patients with these two lenses, and some preferred the Odyssey eye and some the Panoptix eye. So you must be really confused by now. What does it all mean? Which lens is better? The answer is that each lens has unique optical features that need to be matched to your unique eyes. I don't think that I can pick one lens that is better for everyone 100% of the time. It depends on your prescription, on the shape of your corneas, on the health of your retina, the presence and degree of any dry eyes, and on the alignment of the optical elements within your eyes, something we refer to as angle kappa. In some patients, like Robert, where the tests don't show any preference for either lens, perhaps using two different kinds of lenses are better, as I explained above. Look, choosing the right lens is not something you should do on your own. Although it's very useful to educate yourself about the features and benefits of the latest and the most advanced lenses, the final decision about the lens is one you need to make in collaboration with your surgeon based on your eye's anatomy and your personal preferences. But how can you make sure that you're getting the best level of care? I will discuss this topic in detail in my upcoming video, and if you subscribe, you can be notified when it comes up.